In this session, we'll solve problems on entropy. Okay, let us consider a problem. A code is composed of dots and dashes. Assuming that dash is 3 times as long as dot and has 1/3 the probability of occurrence. So what has to be determined? Find information in dot and dash. Second, entropy of dash and dot. And in the third problem, average rate of information if a dot lasts for 10 milliseconds. Okay, now in the problem we see code is composed of only dots and dashes. So as I have only two here, I write p dots plus p dash is equal to 1. This is what I write. Now what is given? Dash has probability of 1/3 of probability of occurrence compared to dot. So I write p dash is 1/3 p dot. Now this value of p dash I will substitute here. So p dot plus 1/3 p dot is equal to 1. So from this equation I get p dot is equal to 3/4. Next, now this p dot 3/4 I'll substitute again in the first equation. P dash is equal to 1. I get p dash is equal to 1/4. I got the probabilities of p dot and p dash. So the first question is information in dot and information in dash. What is information represented as? Log of 1/k. Okay, so if I want information of I dot, it is log to the base 2, 1/p dot. What is p dot? 3/4. So log to the base 2, 4/3. I get 0.415 bits. Okay. Next, I want information in p dash, which is equal to log to the base 2, 1/p dash. Which is equal to log to the base 2, 1/4, which is equal to 4. This is 2 bits. So I got the information in p dot and p dash. Next I have to find entropy of dot and entropy of dash. So entropy is given by what? H of s is equal to p log 1/p or pk log 1/pk. So now p dot log 1/p dot plus p dash log 1/p dash. This is our entropy equation. So that is equal to 3/4 log 4/3 plus 1/4 log 4. So H of S, entropy of the dot and dash source code, is equal to 8.8113 bits per SH symbol. Okay. So coming to the next question, average rate of information if a dot lasts for 10 milliseconds. So what is given is dot lasts for 10 milliseconds. Dot is lasting for 10 milliseconds and this time is allowed between the symbols. So now symbol rate, that means here p P dot is 3 by 4. P dot is 3 by 4. P dash is 1 by 4. For every 4 symbols sent on an average, there will be for every 4 symbols sent on an average, sent on an average, there will be, correct, 3 dots, 1 dash. And 1 dash. Okay. And dot lasting for width. Dot lasting for 10 milliseconds, which is given in the problem. Okay. So a dash for 30 milliseconds. Okay. And with 10 millisecond gap in between two successive symbols. Okay. So here, 4 symbols sent on average, there will be 3 dots and 1 dash, with a dot lasting for 10 millisecond, a dash for 30 millisecond, with 10 millisecond gap in between two successive symbols. So a total of 100 millisecond is required to transmit 4 symbols. There are 4 symbols, correct? We have 3 dot, 1 dash. We have 4 symbols on an average. And a dash for 30 millisecond, and with 10 millisecond gap in between two symbols, we require 100 milliseconds to transmit 4 symbols. So RS is equal to 4 symbols required 100 millisecond time for transmission. So this becomes 40 symbols per second is our information rate. So rate of transmission. So now information rate RS is equal to H of S into RS, which is a symbol rate. Now H of S is what? 0.8113 into 40. So information rate is 32.45 bits per second. So entropy multiplied by the symbol rate at which the symbols are transmitted. So here 4 symbols require 100 millisecond to transmit. That is what we have calculated, because it is being given that a dot lasts for 10 millisecond and a dash for 30 millisecond, and with 100 millisecond, 10 millisecond gap in between the two successive symbols. So here we require 100 millisecond to transmit 4 symbols. So I multiply the entropy with the symbol rate, gives me the information rate. Okay. Coming to the next problem. A zero memory source has a source alphabet S is equal to S1, S2 and S3 with probabilities P equal to 1 by 2, 1 by 4 and 1 by 4. Find entropy of the source . Also determine also determine entropy of its second extension. Okay, that is H of S is your entropy. Second extension means H of S bar 2. This is what you have to determine. Now, you have three probabilities given for the three symbols. So, our H of S equation is now equal to I is 1, 2, 3. Pi log 1 by Pl. So, here it is P1 is what? 1 by 2 log 2 plus 1 by 4 log 4 plus 1 by 4 log 4. Entropy H of S equal to 1.5 bits per message symbol. Second extension, that is our H of S2, is given by 2 into H of S. Okay, that is given by 2 into H of S, which is equal to 2 into 1.5. This is 3 bits per message symbol. And solve the next problem. An analog signal is band limited to 500 hertz and is sampled at microstrip rate The samples are quantized into 4 levels. The quantization levels are occurring with probability 1 equal to P4 equal to 1 by 8, P2 equal to P3 equal to 3 by 2. Find information rate. Find information rate of the source. Okay, so see what data is given. It is given that we have analog signal which is sampled here at 500 hertz Nyquist rate, and the samples what we have got have different probabilities. Sample levels have different probabilities. What are the probabilities? P1, P2, P3 is given. We have to find the information rate. Information rate is what RS, which is equal to R into H of S, where we have to find first H of S, which is the entropy of the source. So we have four probabilities here. Log 1 by Pi. So here we have 1 by 8 and 3 by 4 two times. So here we can write this as 2 into 1 by 8 log 8 plus 2 into 3 by, it is 3 by 8, correct? 3 by 8. 3 by 8 log 8 by 3. So I get H of S equal to 1.811 bits per symbol or level, because we have quantization levels here. Okay. Now we know we have to find what is small rs, which is the symbol rate. Symbol rate here, now we have the signal which is sampled at 500 hertz. So the symbol rate rs equal to twice the Nyquist rate. This twice the Nyquist rate, that is the sampling rate. This is given by 1000 symbols per second. So capital RS, which is our information greater, RS is now 1000 into 1.811. This gives me 1810 bits per second. As the analog signal sampled at Nyquist rate, the symbol rate is twice the Nyquist rate. That gives me the symbol rate. Once I get the symbol rate RS, RS is the symbol rate. RS is the symbol rate. H of S is the entropy. Multiplication of these two gives me the information rate RS.